Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Good Shepherd Catholic College Annual Awards Night for 2020. Award ceremonies such as tonight are a celebration of many facets of college life. To begin the formalities, I would like to invite Isabel de Whale to the stage to offer acknowledgement of country.
Today we stand in footsteps millennia old. Good Shepherd Catholic College acknowledges the traditional owners of this land, the Kalkadoon people, and pays their respects to the elders past, present, and emerging, for they hold the memories, the traditions, and the culture that unites all Australians. We honour the presence of these ancestors who reside in the imagination of the land and whose irrepressible spirituality flows through all creation.
Thank you, Isabel. We now have the pleasure of acknowledging our invited guests who join us on this very special evening, including Father Mick Locock and Father Amene Calamente, parish priests at Good Shepherd Parish, Miss Mary Ellen Pattinson, Acting Director, School Development Services, Townsville Catholic Education Office, Mrs. Helen Wade, Principal of St. Joseph's Catholic School, Mount Isa, Mrs. Claudine Denk, Principal of St. Kieran's Catholic School, Mrs. Samantha Kelly, Principal, and Mr. Shadley Davids, Assistant Principal of Religious Education from St. Joseph's Catholic School, Cloncurry, Mrs. Lisa Clancy, representing the Good Shepherd Catholic College Parents and Friends Association, families, staff, and fellow students. Thank you for accepting our invitation to join us on this special occasion. I am Laura Zabdix, and together with Mitch Nicol, Dan Mose, and Shannon Anderson, we will be your Masters of Ceremonies this evening. Due to number restrictions this year, we are unable to share this evening with many long-term supporters of our wonderful college. We would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge and thank those who contribute to the recognition of our exceptional students each year. Thank you to the Australian Defence Force, Caltex Australia, Clancy Corporation, Good Shepherd Catholic College PNF, James Cook University, Kim Coughlin, Mount Isa Mines, Mount Isa Mining Supplies, Rob Catter MP, TAFE North Queensland, the Zonta Club of Mount Isa, Tom and Helen Tartalin, Tony and Sandra McGrady, and Trek Advisory. Your continued support of awards night is appreciated. Tonight, students years 7 to 9 will be recognized for their outstanding achievements in academic, sporting, cultural, and service areas of college life. As we open this evening with a prayer, may we keep in our thoughts those in our community who are ill and those who are less fortunate.
Let's come together in prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Gracious God, we ask your blessing upon these young men and women who are honoured today for their achievements. We celebrate their capacity for creativity, for critical thinking, and for focused effort. Thank you for their confidence to discover and explore new possibilities and knowledge, to discern what is right, good, and just. Enable them to draw upon the wisdoms and experience of yesterday as they respond to the questions and concerns of tomorrow. Support our students as they continue to go make a difference in the world and lead a life for the greater glory of God. With grateful hearts, we give you thanks and praise for the many blessings we have received throughout the year here in our Good Shepherd community. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Please now stand and join us in singing our national anthem, which will be led by the music department.
Australians all at us for Would you please welcome to the stage our college principal, Mrs. Kathleen McCarthy, to present the principal address for 2020.
Good evening, Ms. Mary Ellen Pattinson, Acting Director, School Development Services, Father Mick Locock, Father Emene Kelemete, fellow principals, representatives from our PNF and College Board, parents, carers, teachers, and Year 7, 8, and 9 award recipients. It is a great delight to welcome you to our 2020 Junior Awards ceremony. While we are disappointed that COVID restrictions have prevented more of our school community from attending this ceremony, we hope that they are still sharing this with us via our live stream. 2020 has been a most extraordinary year for all, but it has not dampened the energy, enthusiasm, or spirits of our junior students. Despite the struggles of remote learning in Term 2, our Year 7, 8, and 9 students have continued to demonstrate their diligence and commitment to their studies this year. They will be rewarded for this evening. Whether you receive a subject prize or the Ducks Award for your year level, you should feel very proud of your achievements, students. 2020 has taught us that despite adversities in our life, it is still important to stay focused on what is important in your life and aim to do well. Blessed Edmund Rice is one of our key founders, and he also believed this. The Edmund Rice tradition is founded on four touchstones: liberating education, inclusive community, justice and solidarity, and gospel spirituality. Blessed Edmund Rice serves as a role model and inspiration for our students. His Christian Brothers Order was instituted to provide free education and help for the poor. In the Charter for Catholic Schools, in the Edmund Rice tradition, it states, "A Catholic school encourages all members of the school community to work to the best of their ability, to become the person that each is created to be, and to strive for equity and excellence." Our aim at Good Shepherd Catholic College is to provide every student with the opportunity to realise their potential in whatever they put their mind to. And this also includes their endeavours beyond the classroom. Tonight, we will acknowledge the Spirit and Service Award recipients. And in a Catholic school, these are just as important as the academic ones. Good Shepherd has a long history of student dedication to serving God and serving others. I would like to thank our Service and Spirit Award winners for displaying the courage to share their Christian beliefs and values with the school. You are the leaders of our community, and you serve as strong models, role models to all. Finally, I would sincerely like to thank our parents and carers for working in partnership with us in 2020. One of our key goals this year has been around parent engagement, and we have achieved this. Despite some disruptions, we have still found lots of opportunities to share the achievements of our students with parents through scholars' assemblies, PNF meetings, board meetings, NAIDOC celebrations, parent information and reporting evenings, and there are still many more to come. Most of them happen to be this week, or seems to be, including our Emerging Leaders Award ceremony tomorrow, and of course our upcoming farewell assembly and graduation end of year events. Good Shepherd's reputation in Mount Isa is built upon a strong partnership between parents, our dedicated staff, and the commitment of our students. We look forward to acknowledging the successes of our seniors later this evening, especially as we wish them well for their external exams, which start next week. They have been the first group through on the new senior QCE system, and we are very proud of the way they have handled the challenges of 2020. Congratulations to all of our junior award winners, and I encourage you to continue to be inspired by Blessed Edmund Rice throughout your learning journey.
Thank you, Mrs. McCarthy. This evening you will notice that there are a number of award categories. A brief summary of these awards and the criteria used to select these recipients can be found in your commemorative booklets. It is now time to begin with our acknowledgements. I would like to invite Mrs. Pelly Morganson to the stage to announce the first awards this evening. I would also like to invite Ms. Dorothy Frew, Indigenous Education Worker Ford, to present the award.
Our Junior Cultural Award goes to an Indigenous student who relates well with their peers, promotes unity and understanding, and has an encouraged cultural acceptance. Our winner this year has been involved in many aspects of college and community life. This young lady has immersed herself in our community through the Emerging Leaders Program and has engaged in working with local traditional owners in the Jungawala cook-ups. And on a parish level, she has participated in our opening Mass, the Mass reading roster, and serving at the Jungawala Drop-In Centre on the weekends. Her excellent academic results, commitment to her studies, and community engagement is to be commended, and she is an inspirational role model, not only for our Indigenous students, but all students within our college community. Our junior recipient this year is Isabel DeWale. Congratulations, Isabel, and thank you, Ms. Doddy. Could I now please invite Ms. Saskia Brown, Curriculum Leader for the Arts, to announce the next awards.
The Arts Awards celebrate achievement in the arts fields. Students receiving this award are ambassadors for the arts, both at our college and in the wider Mount Isa community. Our 2020 Junior Recipient of the Arts Award is involved in many areas of the arts within the college. She also performs in the wider school community, sharing her gifts and talents within the dance and music fields. This young lady is a member of the college band, displaying her artwork at the college open night and participates in state honours ensemble programs. Congratulations to the 2020 Junior Arts Award recipient, Olivia Greenhouse. Unfortunately, she's coming this way. Congratulations, Olivia, on your contributions this year have been a wonderful and remind us that the arts is true and important role.
We now recognise the academic achievements of our Year 7 students. I invite Mrs. Kate Thiney, Year 7 Pastoral Leader, to announce the awards. I also invite Principal of St. Joseph's Catholic School, Mrs. Helen Wade, to present the awards.
Good evening. I would ask that applause be held until the conclusion of this section of awards. I'm very proud to announce that tonight's award recipients in Year 7 include Amarissa Bander, Bronze Award. Cooper Fay, Bronze Award, Subject Prize for Manual Arts. Zita Larson, Bronze Award. Winston Mock, Bronze Award. John Michael Natea, Bronze Award. Aidan Pemble, Bronze Award. Ruby Rickson, Bronze Award, Subject Prize for Music. Neo Silvestri, Bronze Award. Brendan Wade, Bronze Award. Gabrielle Dolzen, Silver Award, Subject Prize for Information Communication Technology. Ryder Pigliafori, Silver Award. Emily Pollock, Silver Award. Shannon Rusham, Silver Award, Subject Prize for Art. Vanessa Strasser, Silver Award. Jocelyn Armstrong, Gold Award for High Achievement in Mathematics and Health and Physical Education, and Very High Achievement in English, Humanities and Social Sciences, Religion, Science, Design Technologies, Drama, Design and Technologies, Engineering and Materials, Media Arts, Music and Digital Technologies. Talia Daniel, Gold Award for High Achievement in English and Humanities and Social Sciences, and Very High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Religion, Science, Visual Art, Food and Fibre Production, Drama and Design Technologies. Mercedes Dank, Gold Award for High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Health and Physical Education and Science, and Very High Achievement in Humanities and Social Sciences, Religion, Digital Technologies, Music, Food and Fibre Production, Visual Art, Drama and Design Technologies, Subject Prize for Design. Holly Greenhalgh, Gold Award for Very High Achievements in English, Humanities and Social Sciences, Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Religion, Science, Visual Art, Food and Fibre Production, Drama, Design Technologies, Media Arts and Design and Technologies, Engineering and Materials. Subject Prize for Humanities, Health and Physical Education, Media Arts and Drama. Caitlin Laffin, Gold Award for High Achievement in English and Health and Physical Education and Very High Achievements in Humanities and Social Sciences, Mathematics, Religion, Science, Digital Technologies, Drama, Design and Technologies, Engineering and Materials, Media Arts, Music and Digital Technologies. Jamison Roberts, Gold Award for High Achievement in English and Science and Very High Achievements in Humanities and Social Sciences, Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Religion, Media Arts, Design and Technologies, Engineering and Materials, Digital Technologies, Food and Fibre Production and Visual Art, Subject Prize for Mathematics and Food and Fibre Production. Mariana Taylor, Gold Award for High Achievement in Health and Physical Education, Design and Technologies, Engineering and Materials and Visual Art, and Very High Achievements in English, Humanities and Social Sciences, Mathematics, Religion, Science, Media Arts, Music, Digital Technologies and Food and Fibre Production, Subject Prize for English. Laura Thiney, Gold Award for High Achievement in Religion and Visual Art and Very High Achievements in English, Humanities and Social Sciences, Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Science, Food and Fibre Production, Drama, Design Technologies, Media Arts and Design and Technologies, Engineering and Materials. Madison Wills, Gold Award for High Achievement in English, Health and Physical Education, Visual Art, and Very High Achievements in Humanities and Social Sciences, Mathematics, Religion, Science, Digital Technologies, Music, Food and Fibre Production, Drama, Design Technologies, Subject Prize for Science and Religion. please join me in congratulating our Grade 7 award recipients.
Thank you, Mrs. Thiney, and thank you, Mrs. Wade. I would now like to invite Mr. William Morganson, Year 8 Pastoral Leader, to the stage to announce the Year 8 Awards. I'd also like to invite Mrs. Claudine Dank, Principal of St. Kieran's Primary School, to assist in presenting the awards.
Good evening. I would like to ask that the applause be held until the conclusion of the section awards. Tonight's award recipients in Year 8 include Thomas Roach, Subject Prize for Music. Grace Butterworth, Bronze Award. Gillian Campuet, Bronze Award. Jackson Constantino, Bronze Award, Subject Prize for Mathematics. Charlotte Edge, Bronze Award, Subject Prize for Media Arts. Bernadette Feliciano, Bronze Award. Darcy Gillett, Bronze Award. Dylan Jones, Bronze Award. Allura Jane Keating, Bronze Award. Aisius Jade Kemp, Bronze Award. Preston Lehman, Bronze Award. Lincoln Macmillan, Bronze Award. Dustin Maloof, Bronze Award. Violet Pye, Bronze Award. Hayley Richards, Bronze Award. Subject Prize for Woodwork. Gabriella Tabone Cook, Bronze Award. Magilia Tabone Cook, Bronze Award. Mila Van Lilyfeld, Bronze Award. Ali Haddon, Silver Award. Anthony Kleinman, Silver Award, Subject Prize for Living Technologies and Health and Physical Education. Natalie Marsh, Silver Award. Ryan Philp, Silver Award, Subject Prize for Drama and Religion. Sarah Pierce, Silver Award. Pratik Sigurlam, Silver Award. Noah Tanis, Silver Award. Samuel Winks, Silver Award, Subject Prize for Metalwork. Fiona Pan, Gold Award for High Achievement in Health and Physical Education and Design Technologies and Very High Achievement in Mathematics, English, Humanities and Social Sciences, Religion, science and visual art, and subject prize for English and humanities and social science. Please join me in congratulating our Year 8 award recipients.
Thank you, Mr. Morganson and Mrs. Dank. I would now like to call Mr. Jordan Harries, Sports Coordinator, to the stage to announce the 2020 Junior Sports Awards. I would also like to invite Mr. Joshua Schofield, Curriculum Leader for Health and Physical Education, and award sponsor Ms. Kim Coughlin to the stage to present the students with their awards.
It is now time to acknowledge the Junior Sportswoman and Junior Sportsman of the Year Awards. Our 2020 Junior Sportswoman has demonstrated determination, enthusiasm and commitment within sports this year. She has represented the college as a member of the Quizzen netball team and was also successfully chosen as a district representative in touch football. Please congratulate our Junior Sportswoman of the Year, Zoe Ryder. Our Junior Sportsman of the Year for 2020 has demonstrated his talents across Queensland. He was a member of the Northern Region Under 15 hockey team and was also selected as a shadow player for the Under 15 Queensland State team. This student has shown dedication and skill towards hockey and continues to excel through his hard work. Congratulations goes to Junior Sportsman of the Year, Brock Phillip. Brock is away playing representative hockey, so won't be able to join us this evening, but we congratulate him on this achievement.
Thank you, Mr. Harries and Mr. Schofield, and thank you, Ms. Coughlin, for your ongoing support of our Junior Sports Awards. We will now enjoy a performance by some very talented Year 11s. Please welcome to the stage Charlie Stretton, Xavier Keys, and Charlie Saunders.
Falling behind in what could be. bring me a higher low. Bring me a higher low. Bring me a higher low. What's that higher low I've been thinking of? World's turning and we're just hanging on, facing our fear and standing out here alone, yearning, and it's real to me. There must be someone who's feeling for me. Bring me a higher low. Bring me a higher low. Whoa. Bring me a higher low. Where's that higher love I've been thinking of? Bring me a higher low. Bring me a higher low. Bring me a higher love. What's that higher love I've been thinking of?
Thank you, Charlie, Xavier, and Charlie. What a wonderful, wonderful performance. I now invite College Principal, Mrs. Kathleen McCarthy, and Parish Priest, Father Mick Lowcock, to the stage to present the next award.
I'm very excited about this one. So this year, we have introduced a new award in our proceedings. The Good Shepherd Staff Contribution Award recognises outstanding school service by a member of staff. This staff member is recognised by their colleagues and the community as being highly professional, displaying excellent interpersonal skills with other staff, students and community members. They are strongly committed to self-improvement and the improvement of their colleagues. To our 2020 recipient, we thank you for your hard work, dedication, and commitment to the staff and students in our college. The 2020 recipient of the Good Shepherd Catholic College Staff Contribution Award is Mrs. Kate Thiney. So a very fitting inaugural winner. Congratulations, Kate.
Thank you, Mrs. McCarthy, for presenting. And thank you, Mrs. Thiney. We appreciate all that you do for our school. We will now recognise the academic achievements of our Year 9 students. I would like to invite Year 9 Pastoral Leader, Ms. Kylie McCarthy, to announce the awards. Father Mick, can you remain on the stage to present the awards, please?
It is with great pleasure that I announce the Year 9 Award recipients for 2020. Again, we ask you to please hold your applause until the end of this section of awards. Tonight we recognise Zoe Ryder, Subject Prize for Metalwork. Liana Woodsby, Subject Prize for Food and Fibre Production. Kane Capuno, Bronze Award. Princess Caceres, Bronze Award. Olivia Lee, Bronze Award and Subject Prize for Drama. Takutswa Mendevitsa, Bronze Award and Subject Prize for Religion. Julianne Mangabat, Bronze Award. Katie Mason, Bronze Award. Jack Pang, Bronze Award. Mark Pullman, Bronze Award. Max Pye, Bronze Award and Subject Prize for Woodwork. Thomas Schlenker, Bronze Award. Patrick Wade, Bronze Award. Gian Angon, Silver Award, Subject Prize for Health and Physical Education, Music and Science. Bella Bakash, Silver Award. Thomas Clancy, Silver Award. Isabel DeWale, Silver Award and Subject Prize for Information Communication Technology. Sinead Donnelly, Silver Award. Lisa Hennessy, Silver Award and Subject Prize for Media Arts. Malachi Munns, Silver Award. Erich Patelkaran, Silver Award. Vonavi Silvestri, Silver Award. Samuel Steele, Silver Award. Danica Taylor, Silver Award. Abigail Constantino, Gold Award for High Achievement in Health and Physical Education and Very High Achievement in Mathematics, English, Drama, Food and Fibre Production, Humanities and Social Sciences, Religion and Science. Subject Prize for Mathematics, Science and Religion. And as Abigail is the highest achieving Year 9 Maths student, she is also the recipient of the Tony Chapel Memorial Award for Mathematics. Congratulations, Abigail. Madison Dolzen, Gold Award for High Achievement in Health and Physical Education and Very High Achievement in Mathematics, English, Drama, Food and Fibre Production, Humanities and Social Sciences, Religion and Science, and Subject Prize for English and Humanities. Olivia Greenhouse, Gold Award for High Achievement in Health and Physical Education and Very High Achievement in Mathematics, English, Media Arts, Humanities and Social Sciences, Visual Art, Religion and Science, and Subject Prize for Art. And Michaela Wills, Gold Award for Health for High Achievement in Health and Physical Education and Very High Achievement in Mathematics, English, Humanities and Social Sciences, Design Technologies, Materials and Technology Specializations, Visual Art, Religion and Science. Please join me in congratulating these talented Year 9 students.
Thank you, Ms. McCarthy and Father Mick. I now invite Mrs. Wood to the stage to announce the next awards. I also invite Mrs. Lynn Gilly-Hughes, Science Curriculum Leader, to present the awards.
Good The Mount Isa Mines Award for Excellence in Junior Science acknowledges students achieving the highest achievement results in years 7 to 9. Our children are growing up in an increasingly technologically and scientifically advanced world. Science is a fascinating subject to study both at school and beyond, and therefore it's important to nourish the scientists of the future. The 2020 recipients of the Mount Isa Mines Awards for Excellence in Junior Science are, in year 7, Madison Wills. In year 8, Tawana Magarira. Tawana is unable to attend this evening, but we congratulate her on her achievements. And in year 9, Gian Engen and Abigail Constantino. Congratulations, students, and thank you, Mrs. Gilliers. I now invite Ms. Lisa Clancy, representing the Good Shepherd Catholic College Parents and Friends Association, forward to present the next special awards. The Spirit and Service Awards are supported by the Good Shepherd Catholic College PNF Association. At Good Shepherd Catholic College, we like to acknowledge those students who demonstrate a willingness to become involved in a wide range of college activities. These students from years 7 to 9 display those qualities most desired in a student at the college: courtesy, respect, honesty, cooperation, and support of the Catholic ethos of the college. I would like to welcome our recipients of the Spirit and Service Awards for 2020. In year 7, Winsome Mock. In year 8, Tawana Magarira. Again, we congratulate her in her absence. And year 9, Isabel DeWale.
Could I please now invite Mrs. McCarthy back to the stage?
Okay, congratulations to all of our Spirit and Service recipients. We also congratulate everybody who has received an award this evening. As our ceremony comes to a close, could I please ask Father Emene to join us on the stage to offer a final blessing for our Good Shepherd community.
Since arriving to Mount Isa in March this year for my first appointment as a priest, it may be my only appointment, I've been really impressed with the Catholic schools. What really impressed me is the intelligence of the students. I've recognized this through my conversations and my meetings. I believe that this is a testament to the hard work of the teachers as well as the students and parents. I would like to commend you all for your hard work, even though we've had a tough year with the COVID-19. There's much for which we can be proud of. You've earned the right to hold your heads up high, applaud your success, and celebrate all that you have achieved this year. Now let us ask our Lord to be with us and bow our heads to ask for God's blessing. We pray for a blessing upon our young people, especially all our students gathered here tonight. We pray for a blessing upon our families, parents and carers, all who have encouraged our young people. We pray for a blessing upon all the staff who has been assisting our students with growth and wisdom. May God bless us all, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Father Emene, and thank you to all of our presenters tonight. I'd like to congratulate all junior award recipients for their achievements this year. Our awards night involved the assistance and support of many people. We thank all of our generous sponsors, presenters, and announcers. In particular, we must acknowledge the college administration team, especially Ms. Taylor Pye, Mrs. Joanne Davis, Ms. Siobhan Russell, Ms. Pilla Greger, Mrs. Cassie Hosking, and Mrs. Claire Denton, for their tireless work behind the scenes in organising this event. To the college staff who offered their support, leadership, and assistance, we thank them very much. This concludes our junior awards ceremony, and we now warmly invite you to join us for light refreshments outside of hospitality. Please use the doors at the rear of the Lumen Christi Centre to depart. For those of you with a ticket to the Senior Awards, the ceremony will commence at 7 p.m. We ask that you all depart at this time, as we are required to wipe down all chairs. Doors will reopen in approximately 10 minutes. Please ensure you have your ticket ready. Thank you for celebrating the achievement of your children in 2020 with us this evening. Please join with us in singing our college song as we conclude this evening.
People who own experience community with Christ our light. With Christ our light.
If you could now make your way out, please. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Good Shepherd Catholic College Annual Awards Night for 2020. Award ceremonies such as tonight are a celebration of the many facets of college life. To begin with the formalities, I would like to invite Shannon Anderson to the stage to offer an acknowledgement of country.
Today we stand in the footsteps millennia old. Good Shepherd Catholic College acknowledges the traditional owners of this land, the Kalkadoon people, and pay their respects to elders past, present and emerging, for they hold the memories, the traditions and the culture that unites all Australians. We honour the presence of these ancestors who reside in this imagination of this land and whose irrepressible spirituality flows through all creation.
Thank you, Shannon. We now have the pleasure of acknowledging our invited guests who join us on this very special evening, including Father Mick Locock, Father Amene Calmette, Parish Priest, Good Shepherd Parish, Mrs. Mary Ellen Pattinson, Acting Director, School Development Services, Townsville Catholic Education Office, Mrs. Helen Wade, Principal of St. Joseph's Catholic School, Mount Isa, Mrs. Claudine Dank, Principal of St. Kieran's Catholic School, Mount Isa, Mrs. Samantha Kelly, Principal, and Mr. Shadley Davids, Assistant Principal, Religious Education from St. Joseph's Concurry. Mrs. Barbara Baker, Executive Committee Member for the Good Shepherd Catholic College Parents and Friends Association, families, staff and fellow students. Thank you for accepting our invitation to join us on this special occasion. I'm Mitch Nicol, and together with Laura Zabidix, Dan Mose and Shannon Anderson, we will be your Masters of Ceremonies this evening. Due to the number restriction this year, we are unable to share this evening with many long-term supporters of our wonderful college. We would like to take this time to acknowledge and thank those who contribute to the recognition of our exceptional students each year. Thank you to the Australian Defence Force, Caltex Australia, Clancy Corporation, Good Shepherd Catholic College PNF, James Cook University, Kim Coughlin, Mount Isa Mines, Mount Isa Mining Supplies, Rob Catter MP, TAFE North Queensland, Bazonta Club of Mount Isa, Tom and Helen Tartalin, Tony and Sandra McGrady, and Trek Advisory. Your continued support of Awards Night is appreciated. Tonight, students in years 10 to 12 will be recognised for their outstanding achievements in academic, sporting, cultural and service areas of college life. As we open this evening with a prayer, may we keep in our thoughts those in our community who are ill and those who are less fortunate.
Let's come together in prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God of all knowledge, who inflames our minds with a passion to learn and to understand. God of all creation, who enlivens our imaginations with the desire to build and to create. God of all hope, who transforms our hearts with a love for all mankind. We praise you for the knowers and the seekers, the builders and the makers, who are gathered here to be honoured today. We give thanks for the wealth of talents represented here today, for the advances in wisdom, knowledge and understanding. We give thanks for the pride we take in our accomplishments as individuals and as a school community. We celebrate with you our success, courses complete, exams written, jobs well done, and simply for who we are. May we never cease to praise you for the light that knowledge, compassion, and understanding bring. We ask this in your name. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Please now stand and join us in singing our national anthem, which will be led by Stephanie Reddish, Peter Mattia, Ella Coughlin, Sunny Woolen Rofa, and Gian Agon.
Please welcome to the stage our college principal, Mrs. Kathleen McCarthy, to present the principal's address for 2020.
Good evening, and before I begin, I would like us all to give our musicians and our band a big round of applause for this evening. Good evening, Miss Mary Ellen Pattinson, Acting Director, School Development Services, Father Mick Locock, Father Emene Kelemede, fellow principals, representatives from the PNF and College Board, parents, carers, staff and students. Welcome to our 2020 Senior Awards Ceremony. This is a wonderful opportunity for us to celebrate the many amazing achievements of our Year 10, 11 and 12 students. Academic excellence and spirit and service at Good Shepherd has not been compromised by the extraordinary year that is 2020. Despite challenges of remote learning and new QCE and assessment procedures, our senior students have remained steadfast in their commitment to their studies and performed admirably. The Year 10 students have begun their preparations for senior schooling and are to be commended for the way they have engaged in the senior education and training or SET planning processes. I encourage you to continue studying hard this year so you have all the foundations that you need to begin Year 11 in earnest. Our current Year 11 students have recently completed their Unit 3 studies. And I congratulate those students who are receiving academic awards for your efforts in Unit 1 and 2. Your attendance at homework program, tutorials, and additional study at home is being rewarded this evening. Be sure to regularly thank your teachers too for their support along your journey to success. I am particularly proud of the positive and resilient way that our Year 12s have approached the uncertainty and challenges that they have experienced in 2020. This mature approach to change will serve you well into the future and hopefully equip you to deal with the many ups and downs you will experience in your life. But you all have a future full of hope and joy. And I encourage you to take every opportunity given to you and work hard to make sure all your dreams do come true. I pray too that you stay involved in the parish and that the religious education and faith formation that you have received through the last 6 years inspires you to lead a life of kindness and compassion to others. Your service to Catholics in Action youth groups, Jungawala, Project Compassion, missions, and charities such as the Cancer Council's Shay for a Cure do not need to end with high school. And I challenge you to continue your service to others throughout your life. Last weekend, we celebrated the 10th anniversary of the canonisation of St. Mary MacKillop. She has long been an inspiration to thousands of Good Shepherd students who have walked through our gates. I congratulate our Spirit and Service Award winners this evening who continue her work by seeing a need and responding to it. You have all done this by following the example of Jesus and showing kindness, generosity, and care for others. Thank you for being a role model of servant leadership. To our parents and carers who play such a vital role in the partnership between parish, family, and school, we thank you for the privilege of being able to educate your son or daughter at Good Shepherd. Our committed and expert staff cannot do their work without your support. Thank you for coming to school events, taking our phone calls, sharing with us the joys and concerns you have in raising your child. We know that research tells us that when there is a close relationship between home and school, a student's academic outcomes and their well-being is enhanced. Finally, I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge in a special way Miss Mary Ellen Patterson. This year, the four schools of St. Joseph's Mount Isa, St. Kieran's, St. Joseph's Cloncurry, and Good Shepherd combined to nominate Mary Ellen for a Spirit of Catholic Education Award. She's dying in her seat right now. So I'm going to ask her to come to the stage, and I'm also going to ask Father Mick Lowcock to join me. Mary Ellen, would you like to stand over here for us? Mary Ellen began as principal of St. Anthony's Catholic College, Dirigan, in 1997, before moving into the education consultant role at Townsville Catholic Education in 2001. It is during her time in this role that the Western Cluster of Schools benefited significantly from her outstanding service to our school communities, with her having been appointed to this cluster twice during her consultancy. Mary Ellen takes a genuine interest in the lives of school staff at all levels. She immerses herself in staff rooms and gets to know our stories. She has a great capacity to develop warm relationships with staff, and it is this sense of connection that makes her so valued. Her role also sees her work with early careers teachers, taking an interest in their development as educators. She provides advice and assists them to embrace our remote location and make the most of all the wonderful opportunities it presents them. We are very grateful, Mary Ellen, for the fact that you have shown great love for our unique schools. You've travelled to us regularly and given so much of your life and personal time to ensure that we are supported and that our schools get the best possible opportunities to flourish. We have continually seen Mary Ellen's love of Catholic education, of teaching and learning, that she has been bringing to Catholic school communities for many years, and we are honoured that our Western schools have benefited so abundantly from her wisdom, dedication, passion and expertise. Can we please congratulate Mary Ellen Patterson? And I'll now hand over to Mary Ellen to say a few words.
For those of you who know me, I hate being surprised. And I just thank you very sincerely for acknowledging what's been just a sheer joy. So, this is the part I've prepared. Invited guests, staff members, parents and students of the Good Shepherd Catholic College community. I too wish to begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land on which we meet this evening, the Kalkadoon people, and I pay my respects to their elders, past, present and emerging. I speak this evening on behalf of the Executive Director of Townsville Catholic Education Office, Mrs. Jackie Francis. She sends her congratulations to all those students whose hard work and efforts will be recognised this evening, and her very best wishes to the Year 12 students. 2020 certainly has been a year of firsts, and hopefully lasts, given our experience with COVID. Schools have managed to negotiate the risks and adjustments to school life, and now we're racing towards the end of yet another school year. For our students and their family, it has been unpredictable, to say the least. However, some things always remain the same. We gather as a community to celebrate and honour the work of those students who have worked diligently to achieve very high results. Really, in the big scheme of things, there's been quite minimal impact for our schools out west, especially when we compare to our colleagues down south. Our Grade 12 cohort will leave Good Shepherd knowing how to contribute to the life of the community. They know what it means to be a positive difference and to be a positive influence in their community. And our Year 12 students do have the skill set to transition into work or further study. It's obvious that the high standards are an expectation at this college and that the staff and students of this community keep rising to all these challenges. Over the past four or so years, I've seen the college staff here work tirelessly to establish the new programs and pathways to meet the state government guidelines for senior schooling, for the senior years of schooling. I thank them for their commitment to this task and recognise for much of that time they've been in what they consider to be unknown waters. The college leadership team, under the guidance and direction of Kathleen, has supported the staff to embed these new guidelines. And I especially appreciate the way that this team works together to support each other and all the students, their families and the staff. The circle is then complete by acknowledging the families of our students who are vital to creating the wonderful educational environment that we see here tonight at Good Shepherd. And to conclude, I'd like to acknowledge the strong support that all our Catholic schools receive from Father Mick. Mick takes an active interest in all aspects of our school life, and he's actively training Mene, not that he needs much encouragement, to invest heavily in our Catholic schools. Mick and Mene, Townsville Catholic Education, really values the partnerships that you show. Thank you, especially to these two dedicated men. And let's get on with this evening's real celebrations.
Thank you, Mrs. Pattinson. This evening you will notice that there are a number of award categories. A brief summary of the awards and the criteria used to select recipients can be found in your commemorative booklets. It is now time to begin our acknowledgements. I'd like to invite Mrs. Pelly Morganson to the stage to announce our first award this evening. I'd also like to invite Ms. Dorothy Frew, Indigenous Education Worker, forward to present the award.
Our cultural award is presented to a senior Indigenous student who relates well with their peers, promotes unity and understanding, and has encouraged cultural acceptance. Our winner this year has been involved in many aspects of college and community life. Our senior recipient is a quiet achiever and someone who is proud of her culture and heritage. The young lady is a strong student leader and has performed admirably in her studies this year. She has made consistent efforts to engage with cultural community activities and engages other students to do the same. For the last 2 years, she has achieved a gold level in the Emerging Leaders Program, the highest possible level. She has also served as a QuadCIF ambassador and participant in the Indigenous Youth Development Program. The worthy recipient of the 2020 Senior Indigenous Cultural Award for Good Shepherd is Shannon Anderson. Congratulations, Shannon, and thank you, Ms. Frew. I now invite Ms. Saskia Brown, Curriculum Leader for the Arts, to announce the next awards.
Good evening, everybody. The Arts Awards celebrate achievement and volunteering in the arts fields. Students receiving this award are ambassadors for the arts, both in our college and our the wider community of Mount Isa. Through artistic practices, our 2020 Senior Art Award recipient has demonstrated observations and insight that are both discerning, creative thinking, and outside the box. Her insight has helped her to curate effective bodies of work that record ideas and which have been communicated clearly and displayed her artistic skills. A reflection on this excellence has seen her work submitted in the Creative Generation Excellence Awards for 2020. Our recipient of the 2020 Senior Arts Award is Grace Elliott. Congratulations, Grace, on your this year that have been exemplary, and we congratulate you on your efforts. Congratulations again, Grace.
I now like to call Mr. Jordan Harries, Sports Coordinator, to the stage to announce the 2020 Senior Sports Awards. Could I also ask Mr. Joshua Schofield, Curriculum Leader for Health and Physical Education, to present these awards.
Now acknowledge the Senior Sportswoman and Sportsman of the Year Awards. Our Senior Sportswoman of the Year is a dedicated young lady who has put a lot of time and effort into netball this year, and her achievements recognise this. She is a key member of the Quizzen team while also being a district representative in touch football and netball, and a Northwest representative in netball. Congratulations to our 2020 Senior Sportswoman of the Year, Charlotte Coughlin. This brings us to the next award, the Senior Sportsman of the Year for 2020. This student is passionate about a variety of sports, including basketball, touch football, and rugby league. He has represented the school in all of these sports while also captaining our college rugby league team. This student always trains hard and shows great leadership skills. Congratulations to our 2020 Senior Sportsman of the Year, Darcy Ryder. The next award is the Overall Champion House Award for 2020. This year's Interhouse Sports has continued to play an important and major role in the college, with enthusiastic students joining our house competitions. As always, points are awarded for students participating in events, and of course, more points are awarded for receiving a place. Not only are there a number of very talented sportsmen and women in the winning house this year, but the participation and spirit from all students has been outstanding. I'm happy to announce the overall champion house for 2020 is Benjamin. Could the house captain, Sydney Corrigan, please receive the trophy on behalf of Benjamin House? Thank you, Mr. Schofield, and congratulations to all students who were able to participate in school sport in 2020. Can I now please invite Deputy Principal Mrs. Michelle Wood and College Careers Advisor Mrs. Fiona Coughlin to the stage to present the next awards.
And thank you to Mr. Robbie Catter for his continued support of our sports awards. The next awards are presented on behalf of TAFE North for students who have demonstrated hard work and dedication in their studies this year. The 2020 TAFE for Schools Trade Student of the Year has a can-do attitude and displays great attention to detail in work tasks performed in class. Their focus, can-do attitude, and passion inspires their classmates. Their teachers often celebrate their quality of workmanship, and with this nomination, believes they are paving the way for a successful career. The 2020 TAFEs at School Trade Student of the Year is Rory Kirkhoffs. The TAFEs at School Health Student of the Year participates well in role play, even when they are challenging. He smiles and carries on. He takes everything he does in his stride and is a very polite student. This young man has achieved excellent results and would make a very dedicated health worker. In 2020, the TAFE at School's Health Student of the Year is Ethan Garner. Ethan is unable to be with us this evening, but we congratulate him on his achievement. Congratulations to Rory and Ethan, and thank you, Mrs. Coughlin. It is now time to acknowledge the achievements of the Year 10 students. I invite Ms. Louise Wiles, Year 10 pastoral leader, to the stage to announce the awards. Could I also invite Mrs. Samantha Kelly, principal of St. Joseph's Cloncurry School, to present the awards.
The 2020 recipients of awards in Year 10 are Mitchell Corrigan, Subject Prize, Essential English. Lance Demiricut, Subject Prize, Food and Fibre Production, Religion, Science in Practice, and Humanities and Social Science. Renee Moran, Subject Prize, Engineering Principles, Metalwork. Hadley Plum, Subject Prize, Essential Maths. Erin Andrews, Silver Award and Subject Prize, Social and Community Studies. Charlotte Fahey, Silver Award and Subject Prize, Physical Education. Julina Hattie, Silver Award. Briannon Moncrief, Silver Award. Mirari Villanova, Silver Award. Ella Coughlin, Gold Award, High Achievement in English, Science, General English, Legal Studies. Very High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Religion, Humanities and Social Sciences, Drama, Certificate 1 in Business, Mathematics, General, Modern History, Religion and Ethics. Subject Prize in General Mathematics, Religion and Ethics, and Modern History. Lachlan Jew, Gold Award. High Achievement in English, Religion, General English, Social and Community Studies, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Humanities and Social Sciences, Science, Certificate 1 in Hospitality, Certificate 1 in Business, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists. Also a Subject Prize in Certificate 1 Hospitality. Faith Finter, Gold Award, High Achievement in Health and Physical Education, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Religion, Science, Humanities and Social Sciences, Drama, Certificate 1 in Business, Chemistry, General English, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists, Legal Studies, and a Subject Prize in Mathematical Methods and Chemistry. Sophie Greenhalgh, Gold Award, Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Religion, Humanities and Social Sciences, Drama, Certificate 1 in Business, General Mathematics, General Legal Studies, Modern History, Study of Religion. Also a Subject Prize in Drama and Legal Studies. Amy Haddon, Gold Award, High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Chemistry, General English, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Religion, Science, Humanities and Social Sciences, Drama, Certificate 1 in Business, Mathematics, General and Legal Studies. Also a Subject Prize in Science. Amy Jones, Gold Award. High Achievement in Physical Education, Chemistry, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists. Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Religion, Humanities and Social Sciences, Visual Art, Design, General English. Subject Prize, Design. Guylan Liard, Gold Award. High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Science, Legal Studies. Very High Achievement in English, Religion, Humanities and Social Science, Media Arts, Visual Arts, General English, Modern History, Study of Religion. Also a subject prize for Study of Religion and General English. Stephanie Marsh. Gold Award. High Achievement in English, Health and Physical Education, Religion, Chemistry, General English, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists. Very High Achievement in Mathematics, Humanities and Social Sciences, Science, Certificate 1 in Hospitality, Certificate 1 in Business, Legal Studies. Hannah O'Shea Breed, Gold Award. High Achievement in Mathematics, Science, Drama, Religion, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Religion, Humanities and Social Science, Visual Arts, General English, Modern History and Science in Practice. Shani Pierce, Gold Award. High Achievement in Health and Physical Education, Science, Physics, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Religion, Humanities and Social Sciences, Media Arts, Science, Visual Arts, General English and Modern History. Abby Pilliafuri, Gold Award. High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Humanities and Social Sciences, Chemistry, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists. And a very high achievement in English, Religion, Science, Design and Technologies, Materials and Technology Specializations, Certificate 1 in Business and General English. Rachel Scrimger, Gold Award. High Achievement in Health and Physical Education, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Religion, Science, Humanities and Social Science, Design and Technologies, Materials and Technology Specializations, Certificate 1 in Business, Chemistry, General English and Legal Studies. Also, subject prizes in Certificate 1 Business, Woodwork and Chemistry. Dipale Sharma, Gold Award. High Achievement in Mathematics, Humanities and Social Sciences, Chemistry, Religion, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Religion, Science, Drama, Design and Technologies, Food and Fibre Production, General English and Geography. Subject prize also for Geography. Willow Shaw, Gold Award. High Achievement in Health and Physical Education, Religion, Science, Study of Religion. Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Humanities and Social Sciences, Drama, Certificate 1 in Business, Chemistry, General English and Geography. Also subject prizes in Humanities and Chemistry. Sophia Simmons, Gold Award. High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Religion, General English and Physics. Very High Achievement in Science, Humanities and Social Science, Media Arts, Certificate 1 in Business, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists, Modern History, Study of Religion. Also a subject prize in Media Arts. Sienna Simpkins, Gold Award. High Achievement in Health and Physical Education, Science, Physics, Mathematics, Methods and Specialists. Very High Achievement in English, Mathematics, Religion, Humanities and Social Sciences, Science, Media Arts, Visual Arts, General English, Modern History and Study of Religion. Also a subject prize in Physics. Sophia Thomas, Gold Award. High Achievement in Mathematics, Health and Physical Education, Study of Religion, Mathematics General. Very High Achievement in English, Religion, Science, Humanities and Social Sciences, Media Arts, Certificate 1 in Business, General English, HAS, Modern History. Also, a subject prize in English. It is my pleasure to congratulate the 2020 Year 10 Award recipients. Miss Kelly, can I ask you to come on back up? One more to go for Year 10, it's a new one. Our next award for Year 10 is sponsored by James Cook University, who are committed to building tertiary aspirations for students currently in Year 10 in Northwest Queensland. The Year 10 Academic Encouragement Awards recognise students' academic progress and achievement to encourage further success, build confidence, and to support student transitions into senior schooling. The recipients of the James Cook University Academic Encouragement Awards are Rachel Scrimger and Shani Pierce.
Thank you, Ms. Wiles and Mrs. Kelly. We will now enjoy a performance by some very talented Year 11 students. Please welcome to the stage Charlie Stratton, Xavier Keese, and Charlie Saunders.
I've been searching, nothing's working, I've been tripping, no one's perfect, chasing visions, just the surface, shirts on backwards, not on purpose, yeah. I've been learning something bigger, expectations, feet were failing, I found blessings flowing from this side of heaven, staring into my reflection, redirecting my perfection somewhere else. When there isn't any progress, leaning truth inside the promise, it is well. Hold my life out in front of me, dreams of who I want to be, and seeing every empty page, I find that everything I am is everything I should be. I don't need to run away. Something's working, heart is turning, vision's clearing, still I'm learning. So what I am, what I am, what I am, what I am, is something more than I can plan. Go tell me now, oh. fall. I don't need to run away. Have I been standing on a stage? You're just a mirror for the face who I've become. Searching for a new escape, I scan the exits that embrace an easy out. Hold my life out in front of me, dreams of who I want to be, and seeing every empty page, I find that everything I am is everything I should be. I don't need to run away. Whoa, I don't need to run away. Whoa, I don't need to run away. Yeah. I don't need to run away. I don't need to run away.
Thank you, Charlie, Xavier, and Charlie, for a wonderful performance. I now invite Mrs. Pelly Morganson, Assistant Principal Pastoral Care, and PNF Executive Member, Mrs. Barbara Baker, forward to present the next special awards.
Ladies and gentlemen, at Good Shepherd Catholic College, we like to acknowledge those students who demonstrate a willingness to become involved in a wide range of college activities. These students from years 10 to 12 display those qualities most desired in a student at the college: courtesy, respect, honesty, cooperation, and support of the Catholic ethos of the college. It is fitting that the Good Shepherd Catholic College Parents and Friends Association sponsor this award, as many of the student recipients, both past and present, have volunteered at PNF events. I would like to welcome our senior school recipients of the Spirit and Service Awards for 2020. For Year 10, Sophie Greenhalgh. In Year 11, Charlotte Coughlin. And tying in Year 12, Lakira Ma and Chris O'Toole. Congratulations to our 2020 Spirit and Service recipients. And thank you, Barb. I now invite College Principal Mrs. Kathleen McCarthy to the stage to present the next awards. The Zonta Club of Mount Isa provides awards for female students who have empowered other women or girls through their service or advocacy. The local Zonta Club of Mount Isa has been active in our community for the past 27 years. The Diane Willis Memorial Award and Bursary was named in honour of one of our members to be presented to a young woman who not only always aspires to be the best version of herself, but also encourages and enables her peers to also reach their potential. This year's recipient of the Diane Willis Memorial Bursary is Laura Zabadix. Congratulations, Laura, and thank you to the Zonta Club of Mount Isa for your continued support. Our next award is the GSCC Young Woman of Achievement Award. This award recognises a student with outstanding sporting, cultural, and academic achievements. This year, the recipient has shown inspiring leadership in a range of service activities, whilst also maintaining excellent academic results. The 2020 Young Woman of Achievement Award goes to Charlotte Coughlin. Congratulations again, Charlotte, and thank you, Mrs. McCarthy. I now invite Mr. Peter Tupperanian, Director of Trek Advisory, to assist in presenting the next award, and Deputy Principal Mrs. Michelle Wood to announce.
The Trek Advisory Award for Excellence in Senior Mathematics acknowledges a talented Year 11 or Year 12 math student. This award, sponsored by Erin Haddon and Peter Tupperanian from Trek Advisory, is presented to a senior student who has demonstrated commitment to their study of mathematics, which is reflected in their excellent results. The winner of the Trek Advisory Award for Excellence in Senior Mathematics is Jake Russell. Congratulations, Jake, and thank you to the team at Trek Advisory for your continued support. I now invite Ms. Nikki Della Vecchia, Year 11 Pastoral Leader, to the stage to announce Year 11 awards. I also invite Father Mene Clemente, a parish priest from Good Shepherd Parish, to present students with their certificates.
Good evening, everyone. The Year 11 students have adapted extremely well to the senior schooling system in 2020. Let us now recognise the outstanding efforts of our Year 11 students. Connor Baker, Subject Prize, Engineering Skills. Mark DeLeon, Subject Prize, Visual Arts in Practice. Cooper Gunningham, Subject Prize, Furnishing Skills. Peter Mattia, Subject Prize, Legal Studies and Physical Education. Patrick Roche, Subject Prize, Certificate 3, Sport and Recreation. Caleb Starr, Subject Prize, General Mathematics. Charlie Stretton, Subject Prize, Music and Certificate 2, Hospitality. Harrison Wilson, Subject Prize, Essential Mathematics. Callum Ingram, Bronze Award. Boston Intervong, Bronze Award. Caitlin Mattia, Bronze Award. Subject Prize, Science in Practice and Essential English. Stephanie Reddish, Bronze Award. Subject Prize, Information, Communication and Technology and Design. Jamie Ahern, Silver Award. Subject Prize, Geography. Julia Sidenjack, Silver Award. Subject Prize, Social and Community Studies, Sport and Recreation, and Certificate 2 in Business. Charlotte Tupperainen, Silver Award. Subject Prize, Biology. Ashley McDonald, Gold Award. Very High Achievement in English, Social and Community Studies, Study of Religion, Visual Arts and Chemistry. Amy Pemble, Gold Award. Very High Achievement in General English, Geography, Religion and Ethics and Chemistry. Subject Prize for Religion and Ethics. Jake Russell, Gold Award. Very High Achievement in Chemistry, General English, Mathematical Methods, Physics, Religion and Ethics, and Specialist Mathematics. Subject Prize for Religion and Ethics, Specialist Mathematics, Physics, Mathematical Methods, and Chemistry. Isabel Steele, Gold Award. Very High Achievement, General English, Social and Community Studies, Study of Religion and Visual Art. Subject Prize, Visual Art. It is my absolute pleasure to congratulate the Year 11 recipients for 2020. Could I please now ask Mr. Jordan Harries, Year 12 Pastoral Leader, to come to the stage to announce the Year 12 Award recipients and College Principal Mrs. Kathleen McCarthy to present.
Tonight, we also recognise the following students for their efforts over the last 12 years of schooling, which has culminated in them receiving awards tonight. Please note that we are only able to award subject prizes for applied subjects this evening due to the external exam schedule. Subject prizes for general subjects as well as college ducks will be presented at our first Scholars Assembly in 2021, when we have a complete and accurate data. The Year 12 recipients are Cody Cherry Ackley, Subject Prize in Engineering Skills. As the highest achieving student in engineering skills, Cody is presented with a prize from Mount Isa Mining Supplies. Congratulations, Cody. Jasmine Dwyer, Subject Prize in Visual Arts and Practice. Matthew Bowler, Bronze Award, Subject Prize and Certificate 2, Hospitality. Grace Elliott, Bronze Award. Alison Godfrey, Bronze Award. Holly Green, Bronze Award. Tasha Hall, Bronze Award. Michaela Lehman, Bronze Award and Subject Prize in Essential English. Trent Philp, Bronze Award. Samantha Pittis, Bronze Award and Subject Prize for Certificate 2 in Business. Madison Ranke, Bronze Award and Subject Prize in Furnishing Skills. As the highest achieving student in furnishing skills, Madison is presented with a prize from Mount Isa Mining Supplies. Congratulations, Maddie. Sydney Corrigan, Silver Award. Julia O'Keefe, Silver Award. Ralph Supan, Silver Award. Panache Timbo, Silver Award. Letitia Martin, Gold Award, High Achievement in Essential English and Science and Practice, Very High Achievement in Essential Mathematics, Religion and Ethics, Certificate 2 in Business and Certificate 2 in Hospitality, and also Subject Prize in Science and Practice. Darcy Ryder, Gold Award, Very High Achievement in Essential English, Essential Mathematics, Religion and Ethics, Sport and Recreation, Cert 3 in Fitness, Certificate 2 in Hospitality, Subject Prize in Sport and Recreation, Certificate 3 in Fitness and Essential Mathematics. Laura Zabedix, Gold Award, High Achievement in General English, Very High Achievement in Chemistry, Drama, Information and Communication Technology, Mathematical Methods and Religion and Ethics. Also a Subject Prize in Information and Communication Technology. Kelsey Verhoeven, Gold Award, High Achievement in Essential English, Very High Achievement in Essential Mathematics, Religion and Ethics, Social and Community Studies, and Certificate 2 in Business, as well as a Subject Prize in Social and Community Studies. It is my pleasure to congratulate the Year 12 Award recipients for 2020.
Thank you, Mr. Harries and Mrs. McCarthy. I would now like to invite Mrs. Michelle Wood and Mrs. Lynn Gilly-Hughes forward to present the next special award.
Our children are growing up in an increasingly technologically and scientifically advanced world. Science is a fascinating subject to study both at school and beyond, and therefore it's important to nourish the scientists of the future. The 2020 recipients of the Mount Isa Mines Award for Excellence in Senior Science are Year 10, Amy Haddon. Year 11, Jake Russell. And Year 12, Jaden Sweet. Congratulations, students, and thank you, Ms. Gillies. Could I now ask Ms. Donna Cole, Curriculum Leader for Vocational Education and Training, and Father Mick Lowcock to the stage to present the next awards. The Vocational Education Award is awarded to a Year 11 or 12 student who has shown great dedication towards his or her studies in the vocational education and training area. It is my pleasure to announce that the 2020 Vocational Education Award recipient is Sydney Corrigan. Our next award remembers Holly James, a passionate, enthusiastic, and much-loved student of Good Shepherd Catholic College. Holly's favorite subject was hospitality, and she is remembered for demonstrating an eagerness to learn and working as part of a team. The Holly James Memorial Award recognizes a senior student who also demonstrates these admirable qualities. The recipient of the Holly James Memorial Award for 2020 is Darcy Ryder. Congratulations, and thank you, Mrs. Cole and Father Mick. Could I now ask Ms. Fiona Coughlin, Careers Advisor, to the stage to assist with the presentation of our next awards on behalf of the Australian Defence Force. The ADF are looking to encourage the next generation of innovators, critical thinkers, and problem solvers. The first of these scholarships is a new award which acknowledges a young person who is succeeding in science, technology, engineering, and mathematical learning areas. The recipient of the 2020 Australian Defence Force Future Innovators Scholarship is Jasmine Dwyer. We now acknowledge the recipients of the ADF Long Tan Leadership and Teamwork Awards. These scholarships are presented to students who have displayed leadership and teamwork within both the school and the broader local community. At the same time, these students demonstrate a respect for both themselves and others. The recipient of the Australian Defence Force Long Tan Leadership and Teamwork Award scholarships for 2020 are, in Year 10, Sophie Greenalsh. And in Year 12, Daniel Mose. Congratulations, Jasmine, Sophie, and Daniel. Our next award recognizes a senior student who has demonstrated commitment and success in the College Work Experience Program. Work Experience provides students with many fantastic opportunities, and we are so grateful for the many local businesses who support our students through Work Experience this year. The Clancy Corporation Work Experience Award is presented to a student who has received positive feedback from their work experience this year due to their hard work and dedication for improvement. This young man was so impressive during his work experience block that he has been offered a school-based apprenticeship as a result. Congratulations to our 2020 Clancy Corporation Work Experience Award recipient, Aidan McCarthy. The JCU Rising Star Scholarship is awarded to a Year 12 student who will attend James Cook University in 2021. The student demonstrates consistently high levels of academic achievement and personal attributes that uphold and champion their school's ethos and a commitment to regional Australia. This student has already been offered early placement to attend JCU to study business next year. Congratulations to the 2020 JCU Rising Star Scholarship recipient, Panache Tembo. Congratulations, Panache, and thank you, Mrs. Coughlin. Could I now please invite College Principal Ms. Kathleen McCarthy and Mrs. Mary Ellen Patterson, Education Consultant from Townsville Catholic Education, to the stage to present the next awards. The QuTSF Young Indigenous Leader Award aims to recognize outstanding leadership from a senior student who is a role model and leader within their community. The 2020 recipient has demonstrated outstanding engagement with community. They have participated in events including the opening of the Design and Technology Center, Jungawala Cookups with Elders, Hospitality Dinner, and Graduation Liturgy. This young lady has contributed to NAIDOC preparations and has been nominated for a QRC Indigenous Award and is the QuTSF Ambassador. Good Shepherd Catholic College is very proud to announce the QuTSF Young Indigenous Leader Award recipient for 2020, Misha Hankamu. Congratulations, Misha. Our next special award is for service to the college community and is the Bob Patterson Award. Bob and Meg Patterson were committed, generous, and hardworking supporters of the college events. They were tireless workers and quiet achievers. This award recognizes a student who demonstrates these qualities. This year's Bob Patterson Award for Cooperation, Spirit and Service is Sydney Corrigan. Congratulations, Sydney. Our next award is the Matthew Totlin Award. Matthew Totlin is remembered as an energetic, enthusiastic young person who was always keen to participate. Matthew often motivated others to get involved, particularly in sports and service activities. This award recognizes a student who also demonstrates these qualities. The recipient of the Matthew Totlin Award for 2020 is Darcy Ryder. Well done, Darcy. The Caltech's All-Rounder Award recognizes a Year 12 student who is involved in a wide range of college and community activities. This year's recipient has shown commitment, a willingness to participate, and a desire to do their best. The student serves as a positive role model and a leader for others. The worthy recipient of the 2020 Caltech's All-Rounder is Darcy Ryder. Well done, Darcy, and thank you, Mary Ellen. To assist in presenting the final awards of the college year, I would like to invite to the stage Father Mick Lowcock. It is fitting at this time of the evening to acknowledge the recipient of the 2020 Deus Caritas Est Award. This award was originally presented during the Catholic Education Week and is one which recognizes loving service lived out with a faith conviction. This award was sponsored by Townsville Catholic Education Office and is presented again tonight. Congratulations once again to Darcy Ryder. The final award for this evening is the coveted Christ Our Light Award. This award goes to a student who has been a role model of spirit and ethos of the college. This student has both a personal and community commitment to Good Shepherd Catholic College's motto, Christ Our Light, and strives to be Christ for others. Giving generously in all areas of college life, this student has lived out the mission statement of the college and has been most supportive of staff and fellow students. The very deserving winner of the coveted Christ Our Light Award for 2020 is Daniel Mose.
Thank you.
Father Mick, could I please invite you to offer a final blessing over our Good Shepherd Catholic College community?
Good evening, everyone. I too acknowledge the Kalkadoon people on whose land we gather tonight. Remember the contribution that they make to our present lifestyle today as well. I feel so proud of these young people tonight. Congratulate all of them. I was reflecting tonight and during the day about two people who came to mind. One is Edmund Rice, the founder of the Christian Brothers, our principal spoke about before, who began education in Ireland. But this year celebrates 60 years of the Christian Brothers are coming to Mount Isa and beginning on this campus. Edmund started school with a bakery and all because he believed that the whole person was important at breakfast before they started school. And so too for us, the whole person is important. That's why we gather tonight to remember the young people who form the future and are the basis of our community here in Mount Isa today. And the other that our principal referred to is Mary MacKillop, who 10 years ago was made a saint in Rome this past weekend. Her dream for bush people to be able to receive an education and formation in faith becomes a reality when we think about 1932, the Sisters of St. Joseph were the very ones who began Catholic education here in Mount Isa. And just short of 60 years ago, when the Sisters of St. Joseph established a secondary school here, San Jose Secondary School for Girls, which is now the campus for St. Joseph's Catholic Primary School on 23rd Avenue. These two people, Edmund Rice and Mary MacKillop, began and lived a dream. These two people are named as two of our houses are named after these people. And they're an inspiration to us all. They inspire us all in Catholic education here in Mount Isa. Their lives of generosity and self-giving can inspire all of us to give much more for others. And so with these saints looking over us each day, and especially tonight, let's ask God to bless us all. We ask a blessing on our young people, all here at the college, and our young people who will be leaving the college this year. And students who will continue to make our college a place of learning and faith into the future. A blessing on our families, parents and carers, all who have encouraged our youth this year. A blessing on all the staff who have been here this year. Staff who will be leaving us soon. You might pause for a moment and think about people who have been a blessing to you this year through this college community. Each one of us is a blessing to each other. And so we give thanks for the many blessings we've received through each other and through all that's happened this past year. And so may God bless us into the future with faithfulness, with generous hearts, with inquiring minds to appreciate all that we've been gifted with and all that we can share with each other. May God continue to bless us, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good night. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Mick, and thank you to all of our presenters tonight. On behalf of Mrs. McCarthy, staff and students, I would like to congratulate all award recipients for their achievements this year. Our award tonight involved assistance and support from many people. We thank all of our generous sponsors, presenters and announcers. In particular, we must acknowledge the college administrative team, especially Ms. Taylor Pye, Mrs. Joanne Davis, Ms. Siobhan Russell, Miss Pilla Greger, Mrs. Cassie Hosking, and Mrs. Claire Denton, and Miss Amy Webb for their tireless work behind the scenes in organising this event. To college staff who offered their support, leadership and assistance. We thank them very much. This concludes our senior award ceremony, and we now warmly invite you to join us for light refreshments outside of hospitality. Please use the doors at the rear of the Lumen Christi Centre to depart. Congratulations to all award recipients. Keep striving for excellence in all that you do. Please join us with our music students singing our college song as we conclude this evening.
Experience community with Christ our Lord.